Hello, and welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use Nmap and SCRCPY to scan a network, identify an Android device, and remotely control its screen. These tools are incredibly powerful for network administrators and security professionals. We'll go through each step in detail, providing comprehensive explanations of the commands used and the resulting outputs. Additionally, we'll discuss preventive measures to secure Android devices from potential ADB attacks by disabling USB and wireless debugging. Android Debug Bridge ADB is a powerful command line tool that allows developers to communicate with Android devices. It is commonly used for debugging, installing applications, and accessing system features that are otherwise restricted. However, if improperly secured, ADB can become a potential attack vector for malicious actors. Here's an in-depth look at ADB attacks and how they can compromise an Android device. How ADB works. ADB works by creating a bridge between the developer's computer and the Android device. Step 1, network scanning with Nmap. To begin, we'll use Nmap, a versatile network scanning tool, to perform a comprehensive scan of our local network 192.168.1.024. The command we use is nmap t4avn 192.168.1.024. This command includes several options to optimize our scan. The T4 option speeds up the scan by adjusting timing settings, making it quicker to complete. The A option enables aggressive scanning, which includes OS detection, version detection, script scanning, and traceroute. The V option increases verbosity, providing us with more detailed output as the scan progresses. Lastly, the N option disables DNS resolution, further speeding up the scan by avoiding delays associated with resolving host names. After executing this command, Nmap quickly identifies a device on our network with the IP address 192.168.1.11. It also reveals that port 5555 on this device is open and running a service identified as FreeServ2. Step 2, specific version scan with Nmap. With the initial scan results in hand, we proceed to perform a more detailed scan to gather additional information about the detected service. We use the following command, nmap svpn t4192.168.1.11vv. Here, the SV option is used for version detection, allowing us to determine the exact version of the services running on the target device. The PN option disables pinging, treating the host as online even if it doesn't respond to pings. The T4 option is again used to speed up the scan, and the VV option increases verbosity to provide us with detailed output. This scan confirms that port 5555 is indeed open and running a service identified as FreeServ2, providing further validation of our initial findings. Step 3. Connecting with ADB. Having identified the device and its open port, we use ADB Android Debug Bridge to establish a connection to the Android device. The command used is ADB connect 192.168.1.11:5555. ADB is a versatile command line tool that allows us to communicate with and control Android devices. By connecting to the device at the specified IP address and port, we establish a bridge for remote control and interaction. Upon successful execution of this command, we receive confirmation that the connection to the Android device at 192.168.1.11:5555 has been established. Step 4, using SCRCPY for remote control. With the ADB connection in place, we use SCRCPY to remotely display and control the Android device's screen. The command used is SCRCPY. SCRCPY is a powerful tool that provides high-resolution screen mirroring and control of Android devices. It streams the device's screen to the computer, allowing us to interact with it as if we were physically holding the device. Upon launching SCRCPY, we see the Android device's screen displayed on our computer, enabling us to fully interact with and control the device through SCRCPY's interface. Preventive measures, securing Android devices. While these tools are powerful, it's crucial to secure Android devices to prevent unauthorized access via ADB. One effective way to enhance security is to disable USB and wireless debugging when not in use. This prevents potential attackers from exploiting open ADB connections. Disabling USB debugging. Open the Settings app on your Android device. Scroll down and select About Phone. Locate the build number and tap it 7 times to enable developer options. Navigate back to the Settings menu and select Developer Options. Find the USB debugging option and toggle it off. Disabling wireless debugging. Follow the steps above to enable developer options if not already done. In the Developer Options menu, locate the wireless debugging option. Toggle the wireless debugging option off to disable it. By disabling USB and wireless debugging, you significantly reduce the risk of unauthorized access to your Android device via ADB. It's important to re-enable these features only when necessary and to always monitor your device for any suspicious activity. Conclusion. Through these steps, we've demonstrated how to use NMAP and SCRCPY to scan a network, identify an Android device, and remotely control its screen. These tools offer powerful capabilities for network administration and security analysis. Additionally, by implementing preventive measures such as disabling USB and wireless debugging, you can protect your Android devices from potential ADB attacks. Always use these techniques ethically and legally to ensure the security and privacy of your network and devices. If you found this video helpful, please like, comment, and subscribe for more tutorials and security tips.